freedom time.
God is going to visit us in a new way this weekend.
like he has never done before. We're talking about the Word of God. There's nothing we are talking about this weekend apart from what? The Word of God. And we have come here for no other reason except that we will sit down and meditate upon the Word of God. Brethren, it is important that we focus on this one purpose. That by the time we finish with this program, the Word of God will accomplish its purpose in our lives in Jesus' name. I want to tell you a story about some things that have gone on that is making it difficult for people to understand the world. You know, if some of you, I don't know how many of you have been, were there in the faith around 1986, those that were, you know, in the old time religion. By that time, religion was the old time. But these days we have, you know, technological digital religion. 1986, you know, being born again was still being called SU. And once S or C is accompanied by you, they know that you are a useless person. You are not important or significant for anything crooked. They know there is no way to get you on the side of error. In fact, those days, parents will mourn the repentance of their children. Friends will wail over the repentance of their friends. Brothers will lament the repentance of their brothers. That was the pattern those days. But from 1986, something began to happen. December 31, 1986. Some of you will hear that there was a time Bishop Idahosa, Archbishop Idahosa, but by then I think he was still Bishop, I don't know now. I think he was still Bishop that time. He was contending. You know, there was news was spread out to the whole Christian, you know, fellowship that some witches wanted to hold a meeting at Benin. And the host was saying, even by might or by power and by spirit, that the church, we will stop them, both spiritually and physically. That the meeting will not hold. And everybody was praying. And the Daosan will be like that, there will be a parade that day. If it's anyhow and everyhow, the meeting will never hold. And eventually the meeting did not hold. They shifted it to Togo that time, not to Benin Republic, and held it there. But the meeting still held. Now that was just one of the meeting in a network of meetings organized by some people that they call the New Age movement. The New Age people are trying to establish what they call a new world order, not the one you are thinking about. And their portion and purpose was that they intend that there will be one religion that is actually no religion in the world. And all these people that say there is one God and I have written a scripture, so everybody must conform to that scripture, they will flush them out of this world. And they will replace it with a religion that, you know, is about yourself. You know, however you are led, in any way the masters or the spirits or whatever, you know, they want to lead you in a path of self-discovery and mystery discovery. And everybody is free, you know, we call it free thinkers, you know, those days. So you have a free thinking religion all over the world. There have been no religion that has any any authoritative anything. And they say that this is a time when this happens, that is when the spiritual powers of people will come out. Now what has been going on is putting the powers down. And they now decided that for this to happen, they have to organize themselves all over the world. This is a movement that started in 1800s. By 1875, there was a woman called Babatsky, Helena Babatsky. And she started what they call theosophy. And in that theosophy, they say that an age is going to pass by 1990 or something like that. An age will pass, and then a new age will come. And all the stars and the planets are going to arrange themselves, inaugurating the coming of the new age. And when this happens, all these things will pass away, then a new age, when men and women will be full of spiritual powers, will now come. She died, and the movement kind of cooled down. By 1920, another woman came up. By this time, her name is Alice Anne Bailey. And I've heard that Bailey is her name. And she started another movement, saying that it's a continuation of what that woman started. And he opened a company, a publishing company, to be circulating the information all over the world. And this publishing company is Lucifer Publishing Company. And the magazine is Luciferian Magazine. And all over the world, millions subscribe to it. Millions are getting it from all over the world. I will tell you how mad the world is going. And even if Satan has a revival weekend, people will attend. Amen. And so by 1986, December 31, they were able to mobilize 50 million people to gather together. And Benin was supposed to be one of the centers. And what was their intention? They said every body will meditate and release all their spiritual power into the air, into the world. What is the thing that they will keep repeating for 25 hours? That the way human beings understand the truth will be altered. That the way human beings understand reality will be altered. And you can imagine 50 million demons released on this kind of assignment. And before you know it, Pentecostal revival became Pentecostal revival. Everything began to go haywire. And they felt that, well, they didn't do it very well. And they will repeat it. 1988 again, by August. This time they were more organized. They did it for 2 days. And they appointed 144,000 witches. Witches, mystics, and shamans. And they were allocated every principality in the whole world. And these witches operated under those principalities, mobilizing governments and all kinds of people, mystics, Aquarius Society, Aquarius Society, Ekanka, Lamok, Rosicrucian, all these things. They were all mobilized into this meditation to alter the way you appreciate the truth. And this time, there were 88 million people participated all over the world. Instead of the Bible making sense to you, it will make nonsense to you. You read it, instead of understanding what's in the Word of God, you'll be understanding something else that is not in the Word, and you'll be talking something else altogether. You just read the Word for reading's sake, then you say something else. Brethren, this is what we are into. And they are working hard through rock musicians, they are working hard through non-governmental organizations, Planned Parenthood, Amnesty International, CNN, they are all working through those groups. Every news media, they are using the press, using all kinds of rock festivals to spread everything. That's what they call a Woodstock Festival. That's what they call the Hippie Movement Festival. They were organizing this promoting fornication, drunkenness, drug abuse, and all kinds of things, and they call it freedom. They teach you to put on dress without putting on the body. They ask you to put on dress and yet you are naked. All manner of things, and they were spreading it. And they go into fashion, they make sure if you come to market, you don't see any good dress except bad ones. So whether you like it or not, by the time you dodge, you don't buy the one who manages. You need to understand what is going on. My people perish for lack of knowledge. And let me tell you, what they are doing has a backing from God. Hello? What they are doing, God is behind it. God is in support. You know, this our God is a wonderful God. Okay, let's go to the scripture so that you see that God is behind them. First Timothy chapter 4. First Timothy chapter 4. God is with them. So you have to make sure that you do another thing that God will be with you. Otherwise, God will deal with them and they'll finish you up and take you to death. Unless you do something else that God will deal with you, that will not make that work. You cannot change it because the Lord has said so. 1 Timothy chapter 4, he says, now the Spirit expressly says, this is the Holy Ghost. And any word of God that is spoken is spirit and the life. The word of God is power. It creates what does not exist. It brings what is not, and it will come to be. God speaks what is not as though it is, and it becomes. God says, in the latter days it shall come to pass. So you can see now. And this is a fulfillment of the word of God. That will tell you the power of the word. It can make demons move and make people go crazy in order to fulfill it. Now the Spirit expressly says that in latter times some will depart from the faith, giving heed to deceiving spirits and the doctrines of demons. You know, there is something going on even today. You see, many of these, money making, or what they call it, networking, these networking businesses, that is where they market and sell things to and false. This network business. As they are networking, they tell you what you are networking and businessing. They will tell you if you get this, then you have some underliners, whatever. They will come behind you and say, you get money. And you see that once one or two people get it in Lagos, nobody else gets it. And you keep hoping that eventually you will become like them and you'll be traveling and nobody goes anywhere. You think for 10 years, nothing is happening. and use it. You are selling. They will draw a circle there, and inside the circle they will make a curve like that. The upper one will be white, the lower one will be black. And they can even put eye on this side. Eye, you know, these two tadpoles have formed, joined together, and the tadpoles become one circle. Have you seen that diagram? That diagram is called yin and yang. It's yin yang. That's what it is. Yin is white and yang is black. The white is the power of good, or God of good, and the black is God of evil. That is assuming that God of good is God, then the God of evil is the devil. Whatever they mean is that good and evil. And they tell you that in your life, for you to be healthy, you must divide your life equally to good and to evil. Otherwise, you'll be sick. That every sickness is caused by imbalance of the forces of nature. Have you heard that before? And then they tell you they'll do some acupuncture and acupressure to balance the yin and the yang. They'll do some water manipulation or vibration to balance the yin and the yang. And you go, you market it, you go, you buy it. You are giving your money to the devil and you are selling devil's business. You have to be very careful about this. They are using all manner of weapons, all manner of techniques to spread this mentality that God is not significant. During the counterculture movement of 1960s, they were challenging the God of the Bible, that the God of the Bible is not a good God. How can he be there and they have this accident? Not a useless God. What is he? The God is omnipotent. Why is he not potent enough to potentate the accident from not happening? And so you see the church trying to say, well, you know, he's not, you know, and the church kept explaining God until they lost touch with the true God, and the church is now explaining another God, but not the God in the Bible. Hallelujah. Brethren, we need to know the ground upon which we are standing. That is why you have to get back to the Word of God. You have to get back to the Word of God. Verse 3 of that portion we are reading. It says, forbidding to marry and commanding to abstain from foods. Are you hearing such things today? Right by the Word of God, you need to understand the power in that word. You need to understand the essence and the nature of God's word. Hallelujah. Jesus said, the words I speak to you, they are spirits and they are life. Amen. The words I speak to you, they are spirits and they are life. So if you want to worship God in spirit, it has to be by the Word of God, according to the Word of God, with the Word of God, in the Word of God. Everything you do must be in the Word. Otherwise, your worship is not acceptable. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Word of God is also truth. The Word of God is truth. Let's go to Ibeme, John chapter 17. Because we want to see a few things about the Word.
There Jesus says, sanctify them by the Holy Ghost. Is that what we know?
He says, sanctify them by your truth. What is your truth?
Your word is what?
So if you have to worship God in truth and in spirit, and the word of God is spirit and truth, then you are beginning to understand now. Are we following? St. Paul said in Ephesians chapter 6 verse 17, he said, the word of God, which is the sword of the spirit can do nothing without the word. You know, before creation, the Holy Ghost was just brooding over the deep. Just brooding. Nothing happened except the Lord said. When the Word came forth, the brooding turned into the creation. And you need to understand the instrument in your hand, the Word of God. It is truth, it is spirit, it is life. God wants us to worship Him in truth and in spirit. And that means we have to worship Him according to His word. God has provided the open door for us come to Him by the blood of Jesus. And He said, if we are to overcome, we are to overcome by the blood and by what? By the word. How do you overcome spirits with what is not spirit? It's only what is spirit that you can use to deal with spirits. They have released their spirits 50 million and 80 something million. That's how many million? Some 100 and something million demons released in just one word of God. Bring all of them to captivity. Because the word of God is active. It is powerful. And it is able to cut into any debt, even dividing what is indivisible. He said, when it comes to bone and marrow, it can separate bone this side and keep man with that side. When it comes to the heart, it can go and single out the thought from the intent. I don't know how that is possible. The thought and the intent can be divided by the word of God because it's spirit. It has no barrier, it can enter anywhere. When it comes to the inner man, it will excite soul from the spirit. And I don't know how that is possible, but that is what the word is capable of doing. Hallelujah. The word of God is spirit and life, and that is the instrument in your hand. And you need to respond to that word and operate by that word. Amen. When we read the word of God is able to make us to be born again. You know, Jesus said, except a man be born of water and of spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. And in 1 Peter chapter 1 verse 23, Peter was trying to explain that. He said, you are begotten again by the incorruptible seed of the word of God. We talked about spirits, it's by the word. We are born again of the spirit, we are born again of the word. Are we born again? Or the word and spirit are the same? Or they walk together, you must be born again of the spirit, you must be born again of the word. In fact, when it comes to being born of the word, it says begotten. something that is used peculiar for Jesus. When you are praying in the name of the Spirit, the being born and being regenerated becomes being begotten. Because the word of God is involved. And it says the word of God is the seed of God. When John was talking, he said, he that has the seed of God in him, in 1 John chapter 3, does not sin and cannot sin because the seed of God is in him. And you want to, what does he mean? What's the seed of God that is in me? And then he said, your word have I hid in my heart that I might not sin against you. So you can now understand. The only thing that can keep you from sin is the word of God. Without the word of God, the Spirit can do nothing. There is nothing the Holy Ghost can do in your life without the word. And we want us to understand that God operates by his word. He said everything that is came to be by the word. Even though it's by the Spirit, but he says by the word. Because the Spirit did it by the word. And everything that is will pass away, and the word will remain. That is why in Psalm 138 the Bible says that God has done what? Has magnified his word upon his name. Can you imagine that? This is not human thinking. This is God thinking, divine thinking. God has decided that his word shall be magnified above his name. I don't know why he took that decision. If you don't like him, you can worship the devil. That is what God has decided to do. And so if you want to walk with God, you need to get to know what his word is saying. That is what makes God move. That you pray in the name of Jesus is wonderful. But if you pray according to the word of Jesus, it is even more wonderful. Because his word is magnified above his name. And that's why he has to say that Jesus is the word of God. Hallelujah. In John chapter 8, verse 32, he said, for you to experience freedom, for you to experience deliverance, it's not by anointing you with good oil. Because falling oil is out of date. It is the work of human hands. That's a spirit out. And you don't really know where it's coming from. The crude oil is from the ground. It is the land of it. So if you go to the south, you need to know it's done with crude oil. In Mecca, there's oil. As the way they say crude oil is the soul of the soil. It can deal with any demon. That's okay. That's why there are no demons in Niger Delta. Anywhere there is good oil, there are a lot of demons there. It could not drive out the demons. Look at how can it drive out others? People are looking for something. Some will get holy water and sprinkle, others get holy oil, some will get holy mantle. Some will get holy blood. Holy is holy. Holy. Holy does not make anything holy. Only the word of God can sanctify. Hallelujah. Yeah. In Acts chapter 20, verse 32, St. Paul was in a feast. He says, I know that confusion is going to come in the church. I know that from among some of you that have been listening to me, there will be katakata in the church, everybody will have his own denomination.
I know that because the Spirit has said that expressly.
Hallelujah.
And he said, many will draw disciples after themselves and do all kinds of things in order to feed and benefit from the church. They see the church as resources for them to draw substance from.
And suppose it,
the only thing I can commend you to, the only thing that can handle this matter, the only solution to this situation is nothing but the word of God. And so in the midst of this confusion that is coming, when I am gone, I am handing you over to the word of God that is able to build you up. Hallelujah. And establish you. When he was talking to Timothy in 2 Timothy chapter 3, he told Timothy, from your childhood you have known the word of God. And the word of God is able to make you wise unto salvation. The word of God has the power, the ability to build you up. It has the power and the ability to make you wise, so that you will be saved. But today, there is a neglect of God's word. I've told you, God is behind it. Let me show you another portion of scripture. Amen. You know, we are serving a God who is terrible to fall into his hands. It's a consuming fire. God is a wonderful God.
And I thank God that we have such a God. Otherwise,
I don't think that the church will make it. If our God is not a consuming fire, if our God is not a God that when the blast of his nostrils, the Bible says that the anger of God comes like an atomic bomb and exploding from his nostrils, and nothing can withstand it. The wrath of God is an explosion. Because it's a blast from his nostrils. And if God gives a blast, then you know that that blast can consume the whole universe. We are talking about blast not from your nostril. We are talking about blast from the nostril of God. Come and see what God says will happen in our days. 2 Thessalonians, we are at chapter 2. Are we there? Just go. It's necessary. It's necessary you read the scriptures. Verse 9 says, because this is what will make you wise and establish you. This is what will save you from the corruption and judgment that is coming upon the world. Verse 9 says, the coming of the lawless one is according to the working of Satan, you the hearing of Lucifer Publishing Company, with all power, signs, and the lying wonders. You will see miracles going on everywhere. And today, the only sign that somebody is, you know, has power or is worth listening to is that he does miracles. And we don't understand that miracles is not a property of godly people. God says that Satan will do stupendous miracles, signs, and wonders. You can't change it. God has decided that it will be so. So when you see them doing miracles, why you don't ask, if God is not with them, why are they doing miracles? It is because you don't know the word. If you knew the word, you will know that God has said that those that he is not with will do miracles. That's what God has said.
In fact, Jesus says, those he does not know that are workers of iniquity, that he will tell, depart from me, will come with testimonies of miracles and signs and wonders and prophesying. That's what God says. But when you don't know the word, you cannot stand in this kind of situation. You have to know the word of God. The word of God says that signs and wonders, miracles and prophesying will be worked by people that God does not know, by people that belong to Satan. God has said so, and it must continue to happen, because it's either the word of God comes or heaven and earth will pass away. Hallelujah. You see how the word can make you established and give you wisdom unto salvation. But then, and with all unrighteous deception among those who perish, because they did not receive the love of the truth. If you don't love God's word, they will deceive you with such miracles, signs, and wonders, and prophecies. You see, with the miracles, signs, and wonders, they are able. God has said so. So they have the ability to deceive you. Except you have the love of the word of God. Hallelujah. Let me go to verse 11. And for this reason, that is because those people did not love the world. They rather want to watch a video. They want to watch TV. They want to read any book except the Bible. Just tell them that this book is delivered from the power of occultism to power of drinking blood under river Niger and the sucking blood by night. Everybody will just go and buy it. Nonsense! What are you doing if you are sucking blood by night? Where you just breathe out the word of God, whether blood or no blood, the sucking will stop, the blood will dry up. What are you doing with people doing useless things? But people like to read useless things. You give them good magazines to look at, they will not. But bring pornography, they will be rushing and fight at any price. Because they do not love the truth, and so they love a lie. And when people love a lie, there is something the word of God has to say concerning it. That's what we want to read now. Because they love the lie, they don't love the truth. Verse 11. Say, for this reason, God will send them strong delusion so that they should believe the lie. Not the devil. Is it in your Bible? Because I want to make sure that I'm not reading one, you know, fake Bible here. Is this thing in your own? Are you seeing what is going to happen? See, that's why you need to know the word. You see, God will, not the devil. And God is not going to outsource the business of the devil. He's not going to give the contract to the devil to do it. Because the devil cannot do God's work the way God wants it to. If the devil is sent by God to do anything, the devil will always do it the devil's way. And the Bible says, God, why those people are using miracle signs and prophecies to deceive those who don't love the truth, God on his side will decide and stretch out his hand and give a strong delusion to those people to believe the deception. Is it in your Bible? Are you going to throw the Bible away? That is your Bible. And that is the word that is true. That's why things are happening the way they are happening. And that's why you have to be wise unto salvation. So Paul said to Timothy, from a child you have known the scripture, which is able to make you wise unto salvation. The word of God is inspired to bring the man of God to be thoroughly furnished for every good work. That no situation is a perfect situation. You know why they happen. You know what will come next. You are not perplexed. But when you don't have the wisdom from the world, perplexity alone will throw you off balance. And you stumble and fall. There is nothing that happens that is a perplexity to me. Because I bring the world into the situation. And when the world comes into the situation, I will relax. Let me say, you saw some crooked men and wicked women making money. They go, they make money, and you know, good people try to say, they didn't know they work. But these people are doing well. They want to arrest anybody, they will arrest, nothing will happen. They want to kill anybody, they will kill, nothing will happen. And let me say that this is so much baffled him. So he decided to go to the house of the Lord and make inquiry. Then when he came into the house of the Lord and sat before the Lord, by the word of the Lord, let him know why those things happen. That worse things are yet going to happen. And it does not mean that God is not on the throne. It actually means that God is in charge. Hallelujah. And so when you are doing, going through, and they are asking you to repent, and you are doing like this, better be careful. I hope the devil is not deceiving you, and you are not believing a lie that will make God to pronounce a curse of delusion on you. And when God makes a curse for you that you never believe the truth, you never live up that life. Listen, let me tell you, nothing can help you. So don't ever push God to the wall. Don't push God to the wall. If you try it, it's a terrible thing to fall into the hands of the living God. And my God is a consuming fire. We need to know the word of God. Amen. So by God's word, we have answer for every situation. If you are looking for holiness, the word of God is there to sanctify you. God will breathe His word into you. His word will take root in you. And how do you receive the word of God, the Spirit? It is not the letter. St. Paul makes it clear. When we talk about the word of God, we are not talking about the letter. We are talking about the Spirit. He said, the letter kills. Because letter is dead. It only produces more death. But the word is Spirit. That's why he said, you have to hear. He didn't say you have to carry it in your hands, or have it on your shelf, or have the software in your computer. He said, you have to hear. And when you hear, you believe. And Jesus said, you have to read. When you read, you understand. You have to take it out of that hardware and bring it into the software of the Spirit. The word of God reading and distributing there is not the issue. You have to be read out of the writing. You have to be spoken out of what is written. You have to be heard. It has to be read. It has to come out and go through the breath of somebody's mouth and go into the air, the ramifications of the air into somebody's ear. It has to be moved in a spirit form, and you know, breath is spirit. Breath, as you are speaking, you are breathing out. Even the speaker, as you're hearing it, you are hearing it because the speaker is pushing the air. Pushing the air in the appropriate frequency that will stimulate the sounds in your ear. Praise the Lord. The word has to be in the spirit form. If it's not in the spirit form, it cannot do anything. If it's just written there, you just read it. Somebody has to read it out. Somebody has to hear it. Then it begins to activate. Hallelujah. So when you read the word of God, or you hear the word of God read or spoken, when that happens, then the Bible wants the hearing of faith now takes place. When you hear the word of God and believe it, that is the beginning of the operation of the Holy Ghost. Read your word, your Bible. Read your own Bible. And pay attention to proclamations of God's word. When that happens, you begin not just believe, you begin to meditate upon it. Joshua 1:8, God says, this book of the law shall not depart from your hand. Is that what's written there? He didn't say it shall not depart from your bookshelf or from your study table. Not from your hand. He said the book shall not depart from where? Book, mouth. If the book has to be changed from hardware to software. It must be put in bread form. He said it must not depart from your mouth. There is book. You have to read it out, speak it out, say it out, and hear it. And then if somebody hears it, then you believe it. You see, now when you have read it out with your mouth, and you have had it, you begin to meditate on it. Let it occupy your mind. If you believe it, begin to meditate on the word. Let me tell you, the devil also operates by various spirits. No spirit moves without incantation. No spirit operates without meditation or concentration. So the devil knows that, but the church does not know. Have you ever seen a lady go to do anything without some saying something? You have to say something before the church will work. Hallelujah.